Hottest act in New York, without any question, where Bella Abzug will soon be celebrating her 54th or 57th, is it? 57th birthday. Shirley MacLaine will be hosting the party, and all of these people have come out to give $57 for Bella.
When are they coming?
They're coming at 10:10. And right here is famous paparazzo Ron Galella, ready to capture the star.
Ron, oh my goodness gracious, isn't that beautiful?
Back.
I'm like a dog. But when do I meet Bella?
Bella, she'll be coming at 10:10. So, Ron, who's here tonight? You're back from Hollywood. You've been away a long time.
I just got here. I really don't know who's here.
I have returned
after 5 months in L.A., the West Coast.
Well, you know,
just saturated with stars all over, gold in the street. I never shot so many pictures in all my life in such a short time.
Well, do you think
my third book is coming out?
Go ahead, Ron. What's the name of it going to be?
I don't know yet. Off guard too. Off guard.
Tell me this. Do you think you have come back?
Get the crash out of the way.
You have come back to New York. You know, does that mean that New York is still number one city in the world, or is Los Angeles going to beat us out?
Well, definitely this is the number one for the marketplace. It's a center of entertainment, you know, it's a top, I would say.
The star should still worry, you're not going to move out of town.
The newsworthy department, it's all here, you know, news-wise. But L.A. definitely is the TV and movie industry is out there.
So Jackie's still not safe on the streets of New York.
And Jackie took a giant step to the West Coast. And I photographed it there.
But you know, still 40 feet away, I hope.
The benefit was called Giant Step.
All right. Okay. Well, Ron, I hope you get a lot of good pictures tonight.
25
Thank
feet
you
away.
For talking
and,
to
I
us.
And I brought my tape measure. And I measured. And Rosie Greer was between us. Make sure I kept the distance.
Okay. And of course, you've got a book on the market.
Back, Corey.
I haven't left. Nice to see you, Ron Galella. Hope you get a lot of shots tonight. Okay? Okay. The people are really zooming in. Lots of people of all ages for Bella. We'll be talking to a few of them later tonight.
Thank you.
Do you live in the Canal Zone or do you live in New York?
I live in the Canal Zone, but I'm a native New Yorker.
You're a native New Yorker and you're for Bella.
I'm definitely for Bella, and anyone who isn't is a very foolish person.
All right. Well, you told them right out there.
Look at the response. Everybody tonight is for Bella.
You're right.
I know it.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Eugenia, for talking to us.
Enjoy it.
And I think Bella's going to win.
I know it.
She's going to be in there.
Right on.
I haven't quite decided yet, but I'm leaning to Bella. Well. Oh. Good. Ah, the star is out for Bella.
Oh, my.
Betsy Palmer and Jacques Bellini. How nice to see you both.
To see you, Curry. What a sweet flower that is.
Thank you. Don't you look grand tonight?
Thank you.
Really? What brought you out for Bella, Betsy?
Well, for one thing, I'm an old friend of Bella's, and I like Bella.
How long have you known Bella? Can you tell us a little bit about your...
No, I wouldn't say that we know each other in the Elizabethan sense, you know.
Oh, yeah, all right.
We know each other for a while. But, you know, to be here tonight is like coming home, because I've got a secret out of this studio for 11 years, and it's so strange to go on the floor and to dance on the spot where I used to sit all those years.
Betsy Palmer discovered Studio 54 first.
Yes, it really is quite something.
Oh my
really,
God,
I like
so let's get it first.
And tell me, Jacques, how did you happen to come out for Bella? Look in the camera now.
I will always be out for Bella because I think Bella will make a good mayor of New York City. And I think Bella, she's a spokesman, she's outspoken, she's a liberal Jewish girl, and I will always vote for her.
Do you think the time is ready for a woman to be mayor of a major city?
There's nothing wrong with a woman.
The time is ready for anything. Human being that is capable of doing the job well. Do the job.
And I think Bella can probably do a pretty good job, huh?
Absolutely. She can do a good job just like anybody else.
But there are a lot of questions, you know, and I think she's going to start answering a lot of the questions, you know, about should the police then be able to strike? There are a lot of heavy political questions I think that everyone has to become aware of before they make up their mind who to vote for.
The thing that I really find particularly outstanding about Bella is that she is really a total human being, really, and so sensitive. It's not that she's just a woman that is involved and being committed as far as the situation and social situation is concerned with the city. This lady just commits herself to humanity. And I think that this is what always comes to the surface of where Bella is involved in anything that she does. It's not always just heart and always just head. She has a lovely combination of the two.
Are you going to be actively campaigning for Bella out there?
No, I live in Connecticut.
You can't even vote for Bella.
I can't even vote, but I love her.
What about you, Jacques? You live in New York.
Well, I will campaign for her. Why not? I mean, she's a wonderful lady. And I say one thing about Bella. It's a lot of people, but very few human beings. She's a human being.
So can we look for a Bella poster in your window on 60th
Why
Street?
Not? And put it in my door.
I like the way you use that
bedroom.
Window, too.
Yeah. Everywhere. Fun, right? Bella's beautiful.
Well, thank you, Betsy. What are you doing this summer? Are you going to be in New York or
I've been putting
summer
together
circuit?
Things with Candid Camera. I'm going to be on this fall.
That's right.
Co-hosting
That's
with
That's right.
Yes.
So of course, we're going to look forward to that.
From Nashville. And then I'll be doing more things in the theater as I do.
Right. Now, summer stock this summer?
Not this summer.
It's the
first time
in a Gunkwit.
I know, it's a long time.
I'm sorry, it's not a secret. The secret is everybody's for Bella. So welcome back to the studio. It's nice to see you.
Viva Bella.
Thank you very much. Betsy Palmer, designer Jacques Bellini. So. Me not again. You're on Candid Camera, Andy Warhol. Face the cameras, you look good in the light. Sure you do.
How's your wife?
She's fine. How's yours?
Oh, mine's fine.
How's Archie?
Oh, he just came back from a long trip.
Where was he?
I think he and Anus took a trip.
Why didn't you bring him out? Isn't he got a Bella button or something? Or?
He has a Bella button, yeah.
Where's your Bella button?
There it is.
Okay, all right. Now tell me, Andy, are you just out because of the party at Studio 54, or are you out because Bella is having a birthday?
Out here because there's a party at Studio 54. Steve Rubell.
Do you know who Bella is?
For mayor.
You're for Bella, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm for Bella.
Okay, can you tell me why?
She's everything I wanted to be.
That's good, that's good. Do you think it's time for a woman to be mayor? You're ready to accept a woman leader in City Hall?
Yes.
I mean, you think of women as pretty much equal, don't you? I mean, you're not a male chauvinist pig, are you?
They're better.
What?
They're better.
They're better?
Yeah.
Well, do you think Bella for president
I think
a few years?
Better than you are.
You better believe Bella's better than I am. I'm not good for much, but...
Really?
Not much, you know. I heard you're out in the Hamptons this weekend.
No, I was here in town working.
I saw. Oh, you stayed in town. You're not getting any use out of that house in Montauk?
Listen, the city's so much better in summertime.
What are you working on? I know you're doing a lot of cock paintings.
I'm doing a lot of cock paintings.
Are you modeling yourself?
I'm painting your wife.
Oh, gossip.
They got off of me, so.
We're not going to take anything off. You can say anything, Andy. We'll forgive you, you know.
Oh, good.
So, go in and have a good time. Look, I know Galella's back. Can you believe it? Yeah. Take a picture of Ron Galella. So, okay, Andy. Ron Galella and Andy Warhol facing off with their cameras. Look at them all taking. You like taking. He's got a camera too. You know, where's your tape recorder, Andy?
Oh, I left it on.
Well, is it you finally decided there's not enough people worth taping? Or?
No, I knew you were going to be here, so, you know.
You're so nice. Are you not taking the tape recorder out anymore?
How come I haven't seen you around for a couple of days?
Well, I was out in East Hampton. I had a fabulous weekend, sure. It was a big party at Southampton Hospital.
Really?
It was lots of fun.
Oh, really?
Governor Kerry stumbled in, and Lee Radswell jumped on a big motorcycle. Yeah.
Did you lose your jewels out there?
Did what?
Did you lose your jewels?
No, I'm not wearing my jewels. Sure, of course I have. There's Steve Rubell, the owner.
Hi,
Studio 54, the one we have to thank for all these fabulous parties.
How you doing?
Well, how do you do it, Steve? I mean, night after night, Andy Warhol, Bella Abzug, Shirley MacLaine. Every time I come in here, there's Warren Beatty or some stars. How have you done it?
You do it.
No, you've done it. You know, really. How do you feel having... It's tough, you know, making a number one club.
I love it. That's why I do it.
You've done it. Okay, and it still isn't a private club. You do let in the general public. Is that correct?
Most definitely.
And you're open all night of the week?
Tuesday through Saturday. We'll be open Sunday through Saturday in the fall.
$10 to come in and party with the stars?
No,
it's more?
No, it's... It's $8 during the week and $9 on the weekend. That's
well,
all.
Thank God it's not $10, Steve. I'm glad to hear that. And you're going to be open right through August. You're not closing for vacation or anything.
Well, we may close a week because we're adding around 7 new drops. We're adding like a volcano. We're adding a wall of light, like the Gone with the Wind light, wall of fire. And we're adding...
A wall of fire?
Right.
Snow, rain, walls of fire, beautiful girls.
Right.
Great dancers. Everything's happening.
We're adding swings. They're going to be swings. They're going to be 40 different swings where people can just swing up in the air and down and all over.
I'd like to see you swing on one of those swings. Come on in. Thanks a lot, Steve.
Thanks. Hello, I like
your
flowers. Shelly Hack.
Well, Shelly, it's nice to talk to you. I bet you're a model or an actress.
Sure am.
With who? For who?
Ford.
Well, of course. You haven't gone over to Johnny Casablanca then?
No, I haven't.
You know this girl here, Myrna Post, huh? Face right into the camera now, you beautiful girls. Why are you out here tonight?
What?
Are you out here because of the party or because it's for Bella?
No, we came to see Bella.
Bella? Why?
Why do you think?
Well, I'm not sure. You tell me.
Lady.
And you wanted to be mayor?
Yes, sir.
Are there any special reasons you have that you think that...
I think she's absolutely fantastic. I think New York could really use her. I think it'd be grand.
I think it'd really use you, too. You're great. And here's Myrna Post, the publicist. Which one's that?
Shelly.
Oh, she's a client, uh-huh. Shelly, tell me.
Don't walk away. I can't see you.
Don't walk away. Do you come out a lot to dance at Studio 54?
Do indeed.
You like it here, huh?
Yeah. Great.
How long have you been in town?
This time, about 6 weeks.
Where did you come back from? Europe or California?
Europe, but I was from California.
Did you do a lot of modeling out there?
Yeah, I did some more Charlie commercials in Europe.
Some what?
I do the Charlie.
A bath commercial?
Oh, you know that?
Is a scoop from Myrna. A bath commercial? Are you going to be naked on TV, or what's the story?
Nothing to see.
Oh, Myrna tells all the secrets. Well, it was nice to see you out here.
Talking to you.
I hope you have a good time.
Thank you. Sure,
and,
we will.
You know, what do you think about the latest modeling feud? Did you read that cover story in New York Magazine?
Yeah, I read it.
Has Johnny Casablanca tried to woo you away from Eileen?
Well, if he has, I'm not telling.
Oh, whose side do you take? Do you think there's room for two or three agencies in New York?
I think I'm not telling.
You're not telling? Oh, I think something's going to happen. Look, here's Bella. There she is. Here's your chance to say hello. The cameras, the lights, the people, everyone rushing over to greet Bella Abzug as she comes in. The applause ringing Studio 54 as Bella arrives. The birthday girl is here. We hope to get her for an interview in a little minute. There's Andy, open mouth agape. Is it Bella, Andy?
It's Bella.
How does she look?
She looks really good.
She has a green hat on.
I like that Scavullo picture of it. It's on all the buttons, too. Bella's here.
Who's the girl that you just interviewed?
Isn't she nice?
Yeah.
Ron Galella, I wouldn't tell you.
Hey, come on.
Of course you can shoot. It's absolute madness. Is Shirley MacLaine with her?
Yeah, Shirley MacLaine is with her.
Having a good time tonight?
Marvelous. And Martin's with her also, her husband.
Great. Okay. The man behind the next mayor. Everybody's streaming in. It's total madness. Don't ask me to do anything sane. Are you having a good time, ladies?
Don't ask me.
What about you? Are you having a good time?
Well, I'm covering this,
Is there a lot to cover? You think the action's here?
There are a lot of people here, yeah.
Okay, what are you going to write?
What am I going to write? I don't know yet. I just got here.
Okay. I hope you get a story. Okay, here we are with Preston Spickler, actor, model. New Yorker for Bella?
Yes, always.
Well, what do you mean always? How long have you been for Bella?
Well, since she ran for the United States Senate.
Have you been an active campaigner, or?
I was an active campaigner then, and I still am. Yes.
Can you tell me what kind of convictions you have that have led you to come out and do all this work for Bella?
What?
Why are you for Bella?
Well, I just feel that she really has New York at heart, and from what I've seen from the other candidates, I see only politics, playing to the governor, etc., and to the unions, and I think she's her own boss, and I admire anyone like that.
Does she have a lot of contact with the campaign workers? You sit down, have breakfast with her, have a cup of coffee, talk to her, or?
No, I've never personally had any contact with her. I've just worked, volunteer work on the Upper West Side for her, but I've never talked to her.
Are there literally hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers who are joining you, helping to elect Bella?
I hope so. I mean, she deserves to be mayor of New York. She deserved to be United States Senator, too. But
she missed that one.
She missed it.
Well,
narrowly.
Say there's somebody out there that wants to help Bella, that wants to work. You're on the Upper West Side, maybe they are too, maybe on the Lower East Side. What do they do? Who do they contact? Can you tell us?
Well, you can contact the headquarters at 55th and Broadway. That's the best bet, is to go through that channel and then find out what you can do personally in your neighborhood or community.
And Preston, what exactly do you do? Do you make phone calls, mailing lists?
Yeah, mailing lists and phone calls, that sort of thing.
Well, I hope you'll get over there and tell Bella hello. I mean, you've got to have a little contact. Is there any question you want me to ask her? I'm going to talk to her a little later. What do you want me to say for you?
that I don't know. I don't know what it...
No question unanswered. She's answered all your questions?
She's answered all my questions.
Good. Now, look, I know you've got a national network commercial coming out for Upjohn.
Yes, for Chiricahua cough syrup. So I hope it runs again this year.
Why not? Get all those residual payments in, right? Okay, Preston, good luck. Thanks for coming off of Bella. It's nice to see you. Okay, ciao.
You come with me.
Do you know me?
You know Corey?
Do you know me?
Corey, yeah, too.
Hi, Ethel.
I'm
Ethel, you told me you were going to come early and beat the crowd.
I know.
I heard a funny
what happened?
Story.
Very hot outside.
Well, you've been stuck outside for any length of time?
No. I had so much work to do that I got delayed.
But you finally came out because I know that Ethel Skull, and I think the city pretty much knows that Ethel Skull is for Bella Abzug.
Yes, I've been with her for 10 years.
That's right. When did you first meet Bella? It goes back a long time.
Yes. The very first time was in East Hampton. They all started to move in, and she came to visit me in the women's movement at my party for the strike for women's rights. And from then on, I backed her.
Well, you've known her a lot longer than a lot of these people who have even been working with her haven't talked to her. Can you tell us about her as a woman, as a person, as a friend?
I think she's grown a lot, and I think she's learned her way in politics, and people have great respect for her, and I think she'd make a wonderful mayor. And she's a very straight woman with absolutely no axe to grind, and she comes with a wonderful family background. It says a lot.
And you know Martin, her husband?
Yes, and they're lovely.
They get along, a good couple
beautiful.
Together.
They're a beautiful couple. They're very homey and very nice.
Do you think we can trust Bella? Have you found over the years that we can trust her, believe in her?
Absolutely not corruptible.
That's important because there's some talk that she may be a fair weather friend, say
no
this
way.
To that group
no,
and not to that group.
No, she's never paid anybody off that way. She is very straight about whatever she does.
She's been straight with you and she's got your vote, right?
Right.
Okay, well, that sounds good. Look, we're all excited. Rosemary's going to be writing up your book, helping you with your book. Your book is going to come out soon.
Yes, it is.
I'm excited about that. What's it going to be called? Have you decided yet, Ethel?
Yes, we're
going
to call Ethel Skull 36 times.
A lot of people are nervous.
Well, that's Andy Warhol's famous picture of me, you know, and it's a 36 size.
That's the only one your husband didn't take.
That's right.
That's very funny.
I was lucky it was at the Met, right?
You were lucky it was at the Met. Ethel, you look wonderful tonight. Who did you dress?
Saint Laurent.
Oh, it's just fabulous, really. And I'll see you out in the Hamptons on the weekend.
Oh, yes.
It's nice to talk to you. Go and have a good time.
I will.
You should have been here early. It's a bit of a crush now.
Yeah,
there are too many Bella supporters here.
Thank God. Never too many. Never too many for her.
Thank you very much. Ethel Skull.
Oh, yeah? I know that person. Now these are famous people back here.
This is somebody famous too. This is Michael Goldstein, not to be confused with Al Goldstein, the publisher of Screw Magazine, but Michael Goldstein, the publisher of the Soho Weekly News, which in itself is getting quite infamous.
The New York Post and New York Magazine are back there discussing what really goes on in New York. That's page 6 in the Intelligencer, exchanging information.
Well, in fact, I
mean, you should score in on that because that's an important moment.
I don't know. Page 6 is looking pretty good, but I find they're a little bit inaccurate once in a while. But anyway, I'm more impressed with the Soho Weekly News.
Thank you. You've
really grown. You've got what's your circulation now?
35,000.
I mean, you really have become a power in the city.
I don't know if we're a power in the city. I'm trying to lose weight, so.
Well, I don't blame you. So should Bella. But the point is this: are you going to come out? Is the paper going to come out and endorse Bella for mayor?
No. I don't know who it's going to endorse. But tonight, no. It's not going to endorse anyone.
Are you out here just because of the party, or are you a Bella backer?
I'm out here because I'm a reporter like everybody else, and therefore I do what I have to do. I go around to the different places and see what's going on.
Well, what's the scoop on Bella's background? I mean, you gave us quite a bit about Mary Beam there with the Gucci purse. Have you got any dirt on Bella you want to spill?
Read next week's paper. There may be something in there.
Uh-huh. Can you tell us anything at all now?
No.
Whet our appetites?
No. No whetting of appetites. That's what we sell them for, 35 cents a clip.
And you can get them at newsstands all over the city. And,
bless you. Bless
I think
you.
It's, you know, you got a lot of good information there. I read it, you know. So why not? You could read it too.
Fine.
Is there anything you want to say about Bella tonight at all, about
this
event?
I'd like to say about Studio 54.
All
I think
right.
It's one of the nicest clubs in New York.
Well, you may not induce You may not come out for Bella, but you're going to endorse Studio 54, is that it?
Absolutely. I love this place. I hope they get their liquor license.
I hope they get it, too, really. That is a political problem that ought to be looked into. What? Well, why haven't they got their liquor license? Do you know?
The reason they haven't got it, because they screwed up the first time around. If they hadn't screwed up the first time around, they probably would have gotten it. Everybody has problems in this life. Apparently they do too. But I presume they'll get it.
All right, Michael, keep on plugging. I wish you'd pay your writers a little more money, but...
we are now.
You are?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, you better call me up. See you later. Mike Goldstein, editor, publisher, Soho Weekly News. Aha, here's Joseph Lee. Joseph Lee, you live in Rome. What are you doing at a Bella party?
What?
What are you doing at a Bella party?
I don't know. I just got here last night.
Tell me, are you for Bella? Do you keep up with in New York politics in Rome?
Sure. I'm for Bella.
You're for Bella? Why?
Why? Because I worked for Bella when I was for Congress. I worked.
You didn't know that?
Yeah, that's before I lived in Rome. When I was here during a senatorial campaign last time.
I didn't know you were politically so active.
Yes.
All right, Joseph, it's good to see you out of Jackie O and in the Studio 54. I hope we're seeing you out in the discotheque circuit before you go back in the fall. Okay, Joseph Lee. Hi, how are you?
Hi, nice to see you. Wonderful to be here.
Well, tell me, how do you happen to be out here today?
Well, I happen to be here because Bella's our mayor. That's how I happen to be here. We need her like nothing was ever needed before. We sent her to Washington and she got that all cleaned up. And now we need her at home. And so we're going to put Bella to work to clean up New York City and get everything going.
Are you
going to
be active in getting all of New York's children out there to vote for Bella?
I certainly am. Dick Ridge.
Hi, Dick. How are you doing?
Marvelous water. Hello,
yeah, I'm really for her. She's great.
Yes, I make speeches at the drop of a hat. She's a wonderful woman. Anybody that could go to Congress, which is pretty chauvinistic, and come out being the third most influential person in just the 4 short years has got to be somebody very special.
Tell me, Ruth, have you known Bella a long time?
I'd say about 8 or 9 years. She was my congresswoman, and now she's going to be my mayor.
Can you talk to her? Is she a down-to-earth person, or is she too busy out campaigning?
Yeah, she's a heaven lady.
Yes, Dick knows her too. She is a wonderful woman.
She's able to communicate with you person to person? You can
absolutely
talk to her?
I tell you, we have sat in a taxi cab, and she has asked me, Ruth, what do you think I should do?
Yeah,
now,
but she's
that's
a people,
how down-to-earth she is. She can talk to anybody. I campaigned throughout the city for Jimmy Carter with Bella, and we were in every borough. We were on a flatbed truck. We covered every neighborhood there is in this town, and there wasn't one place that they didn't know Bella and didn't love Bella. Bella communicates with every race of people, with every class of people. She is a people person. She cares about people, and she cares about New York, and she is one smart lady. You know, there's some people who say, oh, well, you know, the men are afraid of her. She's a you-know-what buster. No way at all. If you knew her husband, you'd understand that. They are the happiest people. When you see her dance tonight, she is a total person. And being a woman is just sort of incidental to it. She loves men. She loves people. She loves life. But what she really likes is justice and common sense. Good sense. She can make sense out of this city if anybody in the world can, and it's a hard job, but Bella's not afraid of work.
When she asked you, what should I do, what did you tell her?
Well, she was asked me a long time ago whether she should run for mayor or not. This was many months ago before she decided. I said, Bella, I don't know. I know what they did, how they ganged up on you, and they did. The men ganged up on her for the senatorial race.
You've been on long enough, honey.
And I said, I'm not sure at this point. But as the time came around, she said, Ruth, I have to do it because my city needs me. And I said, that's right, and I'll be out there helping you every way that I can. And I know that there couldn't be a better person for the city of New York than Bella Upson. And that's the honest to God truth.
Right from Ruth Warwick. She knows.
Thank you
very much for sharing your feelings with us. Goodbye, nice to see you too. Ruth Warwick. All My Children, television star, into the crowd, signing autographs, everyone out here for Bella. Are you for Bella?
Don't cover that,
Mike. Are you
for
Bella?
I want to say, yes, sure.
Well, all right. Well, why?
Because I love her. I think she's terrific. I want to tell you something.
Eileen Afranzin, one of the city's most prominent women, prominent in charity. Do you think that Bella's going to be good for charity? Is she?
Absolutely. That's why I'm supporting her.
I know that, you know, you headed up just really, literally, almost hundreds of committees over the years. Has Bella come out? Has she been on your committee?
Always.
Has she worked to help?
Yes, no. For writers and actors, in the Middle East, she was on my committee for the Irish Bowl. You know very well that.
Is she one of the types that just sort of give her name and doesn't sit down there and make the calls or deliver?
No, she's a very hard worker. Very, very hard worker.
How long have you known her?
1.5 years.
That's quite a long time, really, for you. For you to know people that long, all right?
Come on.
I will in a minute. Thank you very much. Mrs. Franzen, for Bella. New York's most important men, reporters, editors, James Brady. Authors, too. Paris won.
Yeah.
I even read it was on one of the bestseller lists.
Yeah, it's on a couple of the lists. It's doing very well.
I want to recommend Paris won. I really enjoyed it, Jim. It was a good, solid novel, and I enjoyed it a lot.
Okay.
So, what brings you out here tonight?
Well, I'm really here as a journalist. I had a press invitation from Bella's people, and I came out. And New York Magazine is obviously very interested in the campaign, and the Democratic primary seems to be where the action is. So it's very interesting, Corey, to me tonight to see this turnout, because obviously Bella can bring out the showbiz and the beautiful people, so-called. There are an awful lot of people in this room who obviously paid $57 to get in, and whether they're from Queens or Brooklyn or the Bronx or Manhattan, I don't recognize their faces, and that's probably a very good sign for Bella that she's drawing on support from a fairly wide range of people.
Do you have any personal opinions about Bella? You've been covering the New York beat a long time.
Well, I think she's the most colorful figure in the race. I like her as a person. I think she's very able. I'm waiting with a lot of other people to see what she says and what other candidates say on the issues before we make up our minds. But certainly I'd say at this point she's getting the headlines.
Is New York Magazine going to be in the business of endorsing a candidate?
No. The magazine has never endorsed. As you know, the New York Post is owned by the same company. They will endorse. We'll simply cover the campaign, and probably, as the candidates think, we'll be nasty to everybody.
Oh, I hope you won't be nasty to everybody. So, Jim, tell me, how is things shaping up? You've been over at New York Magazine now, what, 3-4 months?
No, 6 months. I went over there in January. And it's doing very well. The advertising ahead, the circulation is staying up, and you know, it simply is the most exciting city magazine in the country, and
well,
we hope to keep it that way.
I think that big article on the cover story that Anthony Hayden Guest wrote on the Model Wars is very exciting. Good reading, very interesting, good reporting.
Yeah, that's an interesting phenomenon. I think this discotheque is an interesting phenomenon, too.
What do you think, Jim? You know, you used to decide what's in, what's out, back at Women's Wear, back at Harper's Bazaar. Is 54 in or out?
Oh, I think it's in. I was here opening night. I couldn't even get in the door, so I think it's obviously in. But you know what it reminds me of, Corey? The dancing madness of the Middle Ages. They're all crazy.
Why don't you get out there and dance a little bit?
I can't dance.
You're going to ask Bella? Why not? You can do it.
She did very well.
Have you got the magazine up to where you want it? You talk about the advertising good. Editorially, as the editor, do you have it where you want it?
I think you can always improve on the editorial, and I hope we will. But, you know, the best writers in America want to write for New York Magazine, and we love that. It's a great showcase for their talents, and it's wonderful for us. But I think you can always improve.
Is all the infighting with the ex-Clay Felker writers and employees, how's that? It must be tough taking over from a man as important as Clay.
Clay is and was a magnificent editor. I think that period is over. We've gone through it. We're now in a period of tranquility. The coup d'etat has taken effect. No, all we're interested in really now is every week putting out a great magazine.
Well, and they.
Thank you. We'll be right back.